Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Heroes, Song of the Ocean. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and I thought he was gonna fight me, and then he changed his mind. Right, so heading back to town to see what's going on. I saved Captain Palman last episode from the wooden soldiers sent by his own country, or his own commander. Oh, look. Yeah, totally not gonna take over the town. No, nothing like that. McBain says, huh? Was there a fight? Una says, what? What? What's going on? It's the scraps of the wood soldiers, says Forte. Hey, you! Don't get near the scraps of the wood soldiers. It may start moving again. Says McBain. We just returned here, so please tell me what happened. Exactly as you can see. The wood soldiers came to Kavara to attack, so we, the 7th Division of the Numeros Army, counterattacked them. Sorry about that. If we hadn't been on our guard, Kavara could have been in a bad situation. You better thank Commander Zenon. We destroyed most of them, but missed some of them. In the meantime, we decided to impose martial law for safety. That's by the order of Commander Zenon. Martial law, says McBain. It's ostentatious. Does that mean old? Ostentatious means like old-fashioned, right? First and foremost, isn't it a foreign interference in the domestic affairs that Numeros imposed martial law for Kavara? It's to assure safety. All the exits and entrances will be closed for a while. Well, then how did we get through? Some of the wood soldiers have escaped from here, too. We are doing this for the citizens of Kavara. Here's Altos. Guys! Ah! Altos, says Forte. It's a disaster, as you can see. Wood soldiers rolled into the city all of a sudden. The Numeros soldiers responded quickly, but many citizens got hurt, too. The International Theater is turned into an evacuation center now, but there are too many injured people to treat them all. That bastard, says McBain. We can't laugh at Zenon because he's not a joke anymore. All right, let's go to the City Hall and meet with Mayor DeMille. Mr. McBain, says Altos. The City Hall of Kavara has been occupied by the Numeros Army. What? Why? Says Una. Commander Zenon forcibly rented the City Hall for the reason of establishing a countermeasures headquarters for the monsters. There are only the Numeros soldiers staying there. No way, she says. They maintain that they are using it to defend Kavara. Yeah, we've heard that. Besides, they did fight the wood soldiers for us, so no one can refuse their request. They're the ones who brought the wood soldiers here. Damn Zenon, says McBain. What do you want to do, Grandpa? First of all, we should go see Mayor DeMille and Ms. Meritos and explain to them what happened. They should be at the International Theater. I'll come with you, says Altos. Altos joins the party. Let's go to the International Theater right away, says McBain. Oh, we're not... Okay, I was going to explore the town. Commander Zenon, we captured Aria, says one of the soldiers. That's exactly what I expected, Zenon says. You know, I spelled his name with an X. I have to fix that in the descriptions. Hopefully I remember. I'm thinking of Zenon as the Zenon processor. With an X. I knew she would come here without fail. The true culprit of the attack of the wood soldiers. The woman who uses the dubious songs as a magic power. I arrest you under the name of Numeros Empire and send you under escort to Numeros for investigation. She didn't send the wood soldiers. She heals people. Oh, there she is. She looks like a lot like Altos. Take her, says Zenon. Can we just fight all of them? I'll take them on. Mayor DeMille says, hold on, Commander Zenon. Where is the evidence that supports she is a criminal? This is pretty awesome right here. Ms. Meritos says, at least you don't have the right to arrest her here in Cavaro. Zenon says, oh, look who's here. Hello, Mayor DeMille, President Meritos. What do you want from me now? DeMille says, do you have any evidence that she controlled those wood soldiers? We have been pursuing this woman who uses dubious songs as magical power for a while. This is not the only problem. This is not only the problem of Cavaro. We've been secretly investigating this for quite a while. There's a report that says someone witnessed her during the attack in Edel. That means it's obvious that she has something to do with this. There can be no doubt about that. Ugh, says the mayor. What a forceful attitude, Meritos says. Excuse me, then. Ugh. We have to go rescue her. The show is over. Get away, says the soldier. Get away. Really? You need to leave, too. I guess we left. It's turning into the worst scenario, says McMean. Una's saying, Altos? I guess he has a funny expression. That woman, he says. No, nothing. What's your twin sister looks like? Telling me to leave, I come right back. Look at these things. Some of them might come back to life, so we might fight some of them. Alright, we're gonna look around the whole place. They're in the theater. You there. They look just like a log, but those wood soldiers are pretty tough to beat. Some of our comrades got hurt, too. It's all crocodile tears. Although maybe he would let his friends get hurt. His soldiers. When my daughter was attacked by wood soldiers, the numerous soldiers saved her. They're not liked because they're from another country, but there's a good soldier among them. You got attacked by those? Even though the soldiers look scary, there's a kind soldier too. He protected me. I wonder who that is. I mean, what's his name is injured, the captain. Luckily, my family was safe, but it seems that many people got injured. I can't believe the wood soldiers attacked the town. You can't fully anticipate what kind of disaster will happen in this world. Without the numerous soldiers, we could have been done for too. I have to thank them. It's all a ruse. I mean, it could be the soldiers aren't aware. This way, it can't be, like, coerced out of them in any way. The wood soldier hurt my grandpa. He is receiving treatment at the International Theater right now. I hope he's alright. So if we can't get into the town hall, how am I supposed to read the latest issue of the Cavaro Times? Hiccup? I'm the savior of Cavaro. Bring me more beer. Ew, he's drunk, says Una. Glory to the numerous empire. Yuck. Yes, very charming. Oh, they're all where's all the patrons? You chased them all out? Dang it. How come no one's serving me food? Are you taking me, the numerous soldier, for a fool? Why are you making me wait? We are not waiters, says Forte. Phew! It's been a long time since I had such a good liquor. This liquor is especially good after we defeated the wood soldiers. You can count on me. Yeah, to be a boasting bragger? Yep, Sure can. I was so surprised. We came here by the order of Commander Zenon to find out this city was under attack by the Wood Soldiers. It could have been worse if we didn't get here in time.
That was all planned. All planned out. You got here just in time because you were supposed to.
The citizens of Kavara are nothing but wimps. There is no one who carries a sword. How come this city doesn't want their own military? The shop manager also got attacked by the Wood Soldiers and hurt. I wonder if the soldiers will pay money when they buy stuff from us. Whew, I have so many things to worry about.
What else are they going to pay with? I don't put it past them, though.
Well, she's up here. I heard that the Wood Soldiers ran wild near the International Theater. I hope Mr. Balthazar is safe. The Wood Soldiers came into the town. I don't want to imagine what could have happened if the numerous soldiers weren't there at the same time. Mm-hmm.
What a coincidence. Hmm.
Hey. I ran to safety too here, but Kavara is under attack too. For some reason, I may be cursed by the Wood Soldiers.
Cursed? And Meritos is at the theater, right? So she's not in here.
The drunk one?
The drunk one!
You know, these people who are milling around, milling about are gone. Hey! The Wood Soldiers may still be wandering. You civilians shouldn't be walking around.
Too bad. Let's see what else going on around here.
I fought with so many monsters in the past, but I've never encountered ones as fierce as these ones. Monsters will feel pain if they are hit, but they don't even feel pain. They kept charging at us until they broke down. They were scary opponents to face. We let several of them escape toward the swamp. I hope there's not going to be more damage.
Oh, you're Captain...
Oh, sorry.
Your captain, intercepted those and got hurt. I guess they have no idea what's going on with their captain. This place is empty. Who would normally be in there? Wait, I need to... So, let's see if they'll even let us into the others... the other zone at all. Walking over here, didn't I? Whoops, didn't mean to do that. Yeah, that person wandering.
I can't believe that the girl with black hair was controlling the wood soldiers. But no one's sure she did it, right? Says Una. But Commander Zenon clearly said she did it. What the? The wound by the wood soldier is already healed. When did that happen? Okay, that's bad grammar. When did that happen? Pshaw. Hello, Grammy and Grandpa. It was frightening. I didn't imagine our town would get attacked by the wood soldiers. I'm glad I didn't let my old man go fishing. I don't know how to thank the numerous soldiers. You can thank them by tripping them as they walk past you. You know, they might be pawns in this as well. It was awful. They say that those wood soldiers headed south. That means I shouldn't go catfish fishing for a while. Yeah, better off saving that for another day. Oh, this is the embassy here. Curious what the response would be. My right arm. I was broken. It was broken, but how come I can move it? That's the miracle voice? She was arrested as a main suspect of the wood soldier incident? Commander Zenon, why? Okay, well, one of his men realizes the truth. I don't know if anything would come of that. Oh yeah, he's not gonna let anyone by. Oh. Same guy. We arrested the party was responsible for the attack on Cavaro. Everything will be clear soon. This building is used by the 7th Division as a countermeasures headquarters for the monsters. Good for you, I want to get in. Alright, so I think this is the only... Well, the bread factory is in that upper floor as well. Upper map. So we can't go there either. Well, they're all hanging out in there. A lot of people here. Whew! I'm relieved to find out my dad is okay. I thought I was dead when I was punched by the wood monster, but a beautiful singing voice healed my injury. Who on earth was she? Somebody we have to go rescue. I heard my dad got hurt, so I came rushing over here, but he's as fine as he can be. I was relieved and feel drained. Relieved yet drained. Who was that girl? She started singing casually and her voice healed our injury. She was mysterious. It was almost spooky. As soon as I heard that song, all the pain went away. Inora, is everything okay with you or your injury? Yeah, it's strange. I'm healed. Really? Oh, good. I wonder if that singing voice was the reason. It was. I don't feel any more pain. What is going on? Getting healed by a singing voice? That's what happened. I can't believe it. Oh, that's the bartender? I thought that was, the maestro. I forget his name. The one who's gonna be a famous, performer in the future. Someone's just asking about him.
wondering if he was okay. I can't remember his name. It's on the tip of my tongue. I can't believe it. My arm is broken by the wood soldier, but it's completely healed. I don't feel any pain. Was I dreaming? Yep. Dreaming. Absolutely. Now these people in here. I was surprised to hear that Wolf got injured by the wood soldiers, but he was healed by the song of the girl with black hair, right? It's so strange. Anyway, I'm glad Wolf is okay. At any rate, is that true that the girl with black hair controlled the wood soldiers? The commander of Numeros must still be half asleep. I can't say it out loud, but I hate the Numero soldiers. Sorry, I had an itch. Hold on 1 second. Okay. They are very rude and have no common sense. It proves that the soldiers are not well educated. The wood soldiers came to town, but I heard that Wolf got injured. Of course, I'm sad that I can't hear his performance anymore, but I bet he is suffering from emotional damage. I wonder how his injury is. I'm so worried. Well, everyone's worried about this guy. I was scared when the wood soldiers came inside the town. Later on, I heard an extremely beautiful singing voice, and all the injured people were healed. I want to know what's going on. A bunch of malarkey, that's what's going on. That lady with black hair, is she a famous singer from somewhere or something? I met her for the first time, but I didn't recognize her. As soon as I heard the lady with black hair sing, I didn't feel any pain from my broken leg. Who in the world is she? She is the magic lady. I can't believe the Cavara was attacked. I wonder if they're going to cancel the performance of Stardust Cantata. That'd be a shame. The numerous soldiers are more likely monitoring us than rather than guarding us. Yeah, I believe it. I can't believe they attacked Cavara, the city of art. The wood soldiers have no sense of the love of beauty. At any rate, because of the soldiers, the scenery of the town is ruined. I am thankful that they saved us, though. Alright, so where's the actual performers? Well, this is a quicker way through this. Actually, so anyone around? Ah. Mayor DeMille says, oh, Forte, Mr. McBain. Thank God you guys are safe, says Ms. Meritos. I heard what happened, Una says. Balthazar, that's the name I was trying to remember before. Many people were injured due to the attack of the wood soldiers, but that lady healed them by singing with a mysterious voice. There's no way she is a criminal. Truly, says Diva Wendy, her voice was that of an angel. It was beautiful, comforting, and bliss. DeMille says, but Commander Zenon suddenly stormed in and called her a criminal. How ridiculous it is to think that she is a criminal, says Meritos. Forte says, to tell you the truth, I was able to hear about a rough scheme from the Captain Palman in the camp. Forte and his friends explained to everyone about the conspiracy of Commander Zenon, which they heard from Palman. That's how it is, says McBain. Commander Zenon's aim was to capture Ms. Aria from the beginning. Furthermore, at the same time, it served the purpose of bringing Cavara under control. He's crafty, says DeMille. Forte says that's why they try to get both Mayor and Ms. Meritos to compete against each other.
Hmm, says McBean. But they didn't go along with the plan, so as a result, it was a failure.
Yeah, so they resorted to more drastic measures.
It was because you stood between us, Mr. McBean, says Meritos.
He thought Miss Aria would appear to save the citizens if he created some incident, says Forte.
I bet Commander Zenon had heard about what had happened in Edel.
McBean says the question is how we rescue her. Unless we act fast, the Numeros will take her to their country soon.
Well, they're already doing it.
She should be incarcerated in the city hall, says DeMille.
Security is very strict there, says Altos.
Things would be easier if we could lure away the soldiers from the city hall, says Meritos.
I have an idea, Balthazar says. We don't think we can beat them with the swords.
With swords, but there's a way we can lure away the soldiers in our own way.
Let's frustrate them.
What is your plan? Asked Forte.
We sponsor the concert and invite the Numeros soldiers.
While then...
I see. I like that idea, says Una.
Did he say more than we were able to read off the screen or something?
Excuse me, says a man's voice.
Zenon, I presume?
Oh, Palman.
Ah, Mr. Palman, says Forte.
How is your injury? Asks Una.
I'm fine, thanks to Ms. Aria.
You're Captain Palman? Says Meritos.
I apologize for our military's irreverent behavior. Please let me cooperate with you.
Are you telling us to trust you?
Forte says, Ms. Meritos, Captain Palman told us everything.
He honestly wasn't informed about the attack on Cavaro in advance, says McBean.
I believe that Captain Palman is seriously offering us his cooperation.
Palman says, I have no intention of returning to the Numeros army.
How about the members in your unit? Asked Forte.
I can't force them to go against our country. I conveyed my will and broke up the unit.
Good. I'll allow him to cooperate with us, says DeMille.
Okay. I have no objection, Meritos says.
McBean says, well, let's work out a plan of operation.
Balthazar says, with the intent to show our appreciation for getting rid of the wood soldiers of the Numeros army, we'll hold a concert at the International Theater. Everyone understand so far?
Meritos says, we've already prepared invitation tickets, so all we need to do is distribute them to the soldiers.
I'll take that role, says Forte. I need to give the tickets to as many soldiers as possible, right?
Yes, says Balthazar. And while we are performing and the soldiers are gathering at the International Theater, you rescue Ms. Aria from the City Hall.
McBean says, as soon as I confirm that the soldiers have gathered in the International Theater, we'll go rescue Ms. Aria.
They still think I'm one of them, says Palman.
So, let me help you there.
Good idea, since you can act freely there.
After rescuing Ms. Aria, we will need to figure out a route to let her escape from here.
Can you find out which road has the least security?
Roger, says Palman.
Okay, let's go with this plan, McBean says.
Balthazar says, but I have one concern.
What is it? Asked DeMille.
I think we should perform Stardust Cantata, since we've been practicing a lot, but Wolf injured his hand, so he may not be able to play the violin.
Meritos says, is it impossible to perform Stardust Cantata without a violin?
No. This piece is not complete without a violin.
How about a different piece?
Says DeMille.
In order to break hold up the soldiers, we need to play a significant piece.
You may be surprised, but Commander Zenon has a great deal of knowledge about music. If we don't perform a piece that he's interested in, he might not even come.
I know for sure a Stardust Cantata will attract his attention.
Well, who plays the violin out of us?
Una plays a flute, right? I think.
I'm not sure.
I'm very sorry, says Wolf. As a matter of fact, Balthazar is right. As Aria cured, I don't feel any pain anymore, but I don't think I'm up to performing satisfactorily. I wish someone else could play instead of me.
Really? That's bad news, says Balthazar.
Forte says, violin.
That's right. Talking of a violin. Alto says, please let me fill in to play the violin for him. Oh, you're Altos, right? DeMille says, do you play the violin? Yes, I have knowledge of it a little. Not a little, says Forte. Altos won the first prize at the recital in Pinzal. I know you can do it, Altos. What a blessing that he's here with us now, says Wendy. McBain says, all right, but we don't have much time. While we are distributing tickets to the soldiers, you can receive training from Wolf. Okay, says Altos. For your information, my training is strict. It's different from an amateur's contest. You are playing, carrying the reputation of Cavaro International Theater. I'm all ready, says Altos. Please teach me. Good. Let's start our operation, says Forte. Meritos says, here are the tickets. Forte and his friends receive a concert ticket. I'm glad we could use the same print work of the invitation ticket. Commander Zenon will believe us once he sees the ticket. It could have taken more time if we had to make tickets just for this operation. Forte read the invitation ticket. The Diva Wendy and the Cavaro Trio present a fascinating performance of Stardust Cantata. Please enjoy a dazzling time of dreaming. Mayor of Cavaro and the Meritos Group. This is perfect, says Forte. All right, says McBain. We are not going to miss any single soldier in town to distribute it to. I'll count on you, DeMille says. Thank you for taking care of it, says Meritos. We're going to play for high stakes against the Numeros army. I have to brace my nerves. I've never had such a thrilling gamble before. Thank you for distributing the tickets. Give away as many as possible if you see Numeros soldiers. Of course, bring them to the city hall where Commander Zenon is. Oh yeah. They're gonna let us through? Da-da. He's practicing. That's not right, says Wolf. Put more emotion in it. Yes, says Altos. Oh, they're practicing hard, McBain says. You understand what I'm saying, right, says Wolf? It's not the right pitch. Yes, says Altos. Wow, it's harsh, Forte says. Grandpa Mac is not even half as strict as he is. Ugh, so frustrating, Wolf says. I would show you an example if I could move my hand. Wolf, says Theodora, don't get so hot. He's got quite a talent to be able to play this good for the first practice. He's got good potential, says Balthazar. I don't trust talent or potential, Wolf says. What's important is whether you're usable on a stage or not. One more time from the beginning. Yes. Altos is working hard, says Forte. It looks like we can count on him, McBain says. Okay. Let's take a peek on the roof. See if there's anything going on up there. What if there's a soldier up here? Oh, not on this side anyway. Look at these tickets. Ticket book. Book of tickets to Stardust Cantata must be distributed to Numeros soldiers. Yeah, it didn't say ticket book. When she handed it to us, it said concert ticket. Just looking around. We got people in different places now. Alright, there's no one up here. No soldier hanging out. Should I talk to them again? Since the Numeros army came, our city is not functioning quite right. If we leave it like this, the elevated waterway will be unusable. They are pretty old, so we need to maintain it frequently.
I wish the numerous army would do a good maintenance job of the city as long as they occupy us. I underestimated the numerous empire and thought they would never invade Cavaro, but I was so naive. I'm not qualified as a diplomat. Gee, here's a pretty business. But it doesn't mean we have lost. If Mayor DeMille and Ms. Meritos form an alliance, they will drive the numerous army away for sure. I wonder if all the documents are in the data room. I never cared about those documents, but I become anxious if they're not nearby. I didn't know I was a pretty hard worker. Damn numerous soldiers. I hope they're treating books right. Me too. Me too. Alright, so these people might have been here all along, I just didn't go in there. If we keep allowing the numerous army to do what they want to do, our pride as a citizen of Cavaro will be hurt. Miss Aria saved us, the citizens of Cavaro. We must lead this plan successfully. I will teach the soldiers that music is more powerful than a sword. Deswolf. We can't thank Miss Aria enough. Without her, I couldn't have been able to play the violin again. If I can help Aria by training this kid, I will do whatever it takes. Anyway, we don't have much time. Training, training, and nothing but training. I know in my head, but I can't play well. It's frustrating. I've almost got a grasp on it, though. I'll master this piece without fail. I'll say that sentence with fail. Okay. Oh, what about this way? Roping the numerous soldiers in music? What a thrilling plan. That's how the people in the City of Art fight. Is it true that they need permission from the numerous army to hold a concert? How come they need permission from the numerous for the concert held in Cavaro? Who does Commander Zenon think he is? I don't know, but I want to punch him in his little face. That Altos guy can produce pretty good sound. He has a good sense, too. I'll be glad to hear that. If he ever does. Oh! Hi. Glad to see you all safe. What? Are you the one at the reception desk? Asked Forte. Yes, since the city hall is occupied by the numerous army, I'm working here now. I heard all about that plan. I'll welcome the numerous soldiers with a smile when they arrive. I'm happy that I can be of help. Okay. That's it. That should be everybody.